In this video, we'll be taking a look at two studies of the effectiveness of spinal manipulative therapy for lower back pain. Let's define spinal manipulative therapy. It's a technique of using the hands or a device to apply a controlled thrust to a joint of your spine. It's performed by chiropractors, osteopathic physicians, and physical therapists. Spinal manipulation was theoretically designed to relieve pressure on the joints, reduce inflammation, and improve nerve function. To use everyday words, we crack your back to make it feel better. The first study from 2013 examined over 2,000 participants with low back pain who had received spinal manipulation and compared it with known inactive treatments. Specifically, the researchers were interested in comparing the effectiveness of the different treatments on pain, function, perceived recovery, return to work, and quality of life over the course of 1 month, 3 to 6 months, and 12 months. The results showed low quality evidence of no difference in the effects of spinal manipulation compared with inactive therapies or sham spinal manipulation. Sham spinal manipulations act as the placebo or inactive treatment in the experiment. I go over the placebo effect in a previous video if you want to check it out. Links will be provided in the description box below. It was expected that the effects of spinal manipulation would be greater than that of exercise or physical therapy. Unfortunately, the results did not support that conclusion. To be fair, it's important to note that the quality of evidence from the majority of the studies were poor, which was likely a result of the small sample size and the required conditions. Although the researchers in this 2013 study lacked access to quality evidence, they conclude that the more pertinent question now is not will spinal manipulation help relieve my low back pain, but rather how can I prevent low back pain? A similar study conducted in 2019 with over 9,000 participants supported the same conclusions made in the 2013 study. That is, spinal manipulation produces similar effects to recommended therapies for lower back pain. This study did find evidence that showed spinal manipulation is more effective than non-recommended interventions to improve function in the short term. Based on current science, there are alternatives to spinal manipulation for low back pain, which may be more affordable and are readily available for patients. Some studies list spinal manipulation as a cost-effective option for the treatment of low back pain, but this conclusion was based only on a handful of studies that did not conduct thorough economic evaluations. For spinal manipulation, a licensed professional needs to be present to administer the proper technique. This hands-on treatment of the spine includes both manipulation and mobilization. The former is a passive technique where the therapist applies direct force at or near the end of the passive range of motion. That's that crack sound when you're manipulated. For physical therapy, the therapist provides the equipment or guidance as necessary. They may also provide a set of stretching exercises and provide patients with electrical stimulation or ice packs to soothe the muscles. Similarly, yoga and other home exercises may require an instructor or trainer, but there's a vast library of resources found online as well. This may require more diligence on the patient's part, but it's far more accessible and an affordable option. The good news is that people who suffer from back pain have options and can choose between spinal manipulation, physical therapy, and home exercises. It will all depend on your need for guidance, your discipline in performing those treatments, and the size of your pocketbook. Until next time, this is Dr. Shim.